Hi guys, Matthew Woodward here, and I have a quick tip today that will teach you how to use Google Analytics to get more traffic to your website. I'll show you exactly how to create a custom profile and set up my personal magic filter, and finally, how I use this technique daily to grow traffic. So let's log into Analytics. So this is the main analytics screen. And if we come and have a look at traffic sources here, you can see that a third of my traffic comes from referring sites. And if we have a look at those, you can see that we just get a big long list of the domains. There's no way to see just get a big list of the URLs that sent you traffic. You have to click into the domain, and then you even get the path. You don't actually get the full URL, which is a bit of a problem because it's nice to know exactly which URLs are sending you traffic and being able to go and respond to that. So we have to create a custom report and then also apply a certain filter, and that allows us to extract some user-defined values. And you can see in my report here, custom, user-defined, and we now get a list of the URLs sending us traffic. I can also come and click on my goals up here and see which of those are driving the best conversion rates, which are subscribing to my email list, which are clicking on affiliate links and things like that. So you might be wondering how we actually use this to get more traffic. Well, first of all, if we take a look at the URLs, that's a post on Black Hat World. There might be outstanding questions on there or responses. I can reply to that, and that will bump the thread to the top of the forum and bring in more traffic. Pro Blogger, I got featured on Pro Blogger, so there may be comments there to respond to, people asking questions and things, which will again bring me more traffic. We've got another forum topic from Black Hat World, another one from Traffic Planet there. The True Valhalla blog included me in their income report. Perhaps again, there's comments. I've actually since added him on Twitter. We've had a few conversations through email and might end up doing a couple of things together. So you can see how having this report available, and you know, if I make the full list of URLs here, how you can just work through this list. Get in touch with people, look at all these different threads here that I can go through and answer and bump to bring more traffic. Now, I do this on a weekly basis, and once you've set this report up once, you can just come in here, browse to it, and then export it as a spreadsheet and just work through the list. And like I said, I do this on a weekly basis just as a way to keep traffic coming from targeted sources. It's really easy to do. So let's take a look at how we actually go about setting up this report. Now this is really, really easy to do. So this is your normal analytics screen. If you come and click on admin and then select your profile, you can see this is my referrals profile that I've just shown you, but I'm going to show you how to create this. So click on your actual profile here and then go to profile settings, copy this profile, and we're going to name it. So I'm just going to name it matthewwoodward.co.uk tutorial and click on copy profile, and you will see the new profile is available here. So select it, and we go on to filters, new filter, and we can create a new filter and we can give it a name. So I'm going to call it referring URLs, and it is a custom filter that is advanced, and in field A, to extract A, we want referral in here. Let me find it. There it is. And in this box, you want to open bracket, full stop, asterisk, close bracket. And these you leave blank. Output to constructor is user defined. And in this field, $A1. Field A required yes, field B required no, override output field yes, case sensitive no, and then click on save. And that is it. That is the custom profile and filter ready to rock and roll. So if we jump into the profile now, which you can do by coming up here, and you can see the new profile there. And oh, one moment, we're stuck in admin. There we go. So at the minute, there's no visits. It takes 24 hours to start populating this report. But once you've done that, we do actually need to create an advanced segment, and I will show you why. If we come to my report here and custom user defined, you'll actually see there's quite a lot of junk that comes in here. There's some results from my split tests here. I'm actually split testing my logo at the moment. That's providing some very interesting results. I'll be publishing that shortly. But we're also getting results from Google and Facebook. So to remove those, if you come to advanced segments here, my one I've called excludes. And if I just apply that, you'll see that all the Google and Facebook stuff disappears. So to create that, you just click on new custom segment, and I will show you how I've got mine set up here. So I'm, you can ignore these three, these are for my split test, but you will say exclude user defined value containing www.google. And you want to click to add an and statement, exclude user defined value containing www.facebook. And if there are any other junk results, you can preview the segment down here. If there are any other junk results, let me show you removing inbound.org, because that doesn't provide the full URL quickly. Add and statement, add a dimension or metric, user defined value, change that to exclude containing www.inbound. And if we preview the segment here, oh, it's removed www.inbound.org, but not without the w dot. So we can tweak this to just be inbound.org. Preview the segment again. And you can see those results are gone now. So you do need to just quickly set up that custom segment just to remove any junk results. But that is it. That is how you get a full URL list out, and you can begin working through these to increase traffic further to your blog. It's as simple as that.